think the way I'd describe Metroid Prime 3 to someone who's never heard of it or seen it before is it's a first-person adventure. It's played from your perspective, through the eyes of the character, and it's an adventure game. There are shooting elements to it, but mainly it's about discovery of your environment, finding new abilities, and traveling to different worlds, and generally about exploration. We always knew it was going to be for the Wii, but we started development on the game before we actually had the hardware. So we started with the core ideas for the game, knowing that these were the basic ideas and the basic structure that we wanted to have for the next Metro Prime game. But we did not receive the information about the Wii controller until we were well into development, until we were almost 9 months into development. And then we got a big surprise of, hey, this is what we're going to do for the next console. So many things had to be refactored, and actually many things fell right into place. The Wii remote, in respect to the MP3, offers us the ability to do things better than we hadn't previously done in other games. The Metro Prime franchise has mainly been about exploration and not necessarily about shooting. While we still have that focus in the Metro Prime 3 game, we were able to concentrate on combat a little bit more, make it more compelling, make it a little bit faster, allow the player to move better in the environment, so that now not only was it an interesting adventure game, but we also were able to add that combat component to it that maybe we had to slow down in the previous games because of the control scheme. We spent a great deal of time and research on how the controls should work and what people do when they actually play these games. And I think that all too often with the initial games on the Wii, the thought was, let's do as many interesting things as we can with the controller, even though they might not have a direct connection to what the player is doing. And that often comes off as feeling kind of contrived, or, man, the Wii controller doesn't work that well. But what we tried to do with Metro Prime 3, and hopefully we as the developers will continue to do, and other developers, is think of things and develop ideas and mechanics that make the player feel that there's a relationship between what I'm doing in my hand and what's being related on screen. And I think that was the number one lesson we learned, and I think other developers are going to learn as well as they continue to work with the Wii. As far as pushing the limits of the Wii, we were able to definitely add things that we weren't able to do before, like bloom lighting, larger textures, more polygons, bigger vistas, more characters on screen. So as far as if we push the Wii as far as it can go right now, it's our first game with this new hardware, so it's hard to tell at this point, but I think we've pushed it pretty hard. We are taking a break from Metroid series and from Samus, so I think that I'm sure there will be other titles created, but as far as the Retro Studios is concerned, we're taking a break for a little bit.